Hey guys, it's Nate, aka The Foot Accountant. Welcome back to the channel. Happy Monday, first Monday of the new year, of course. And today we're asking the question, with the new year starting, is EA going to continue their trend of upgrade packs on Mondays? Now, I'm not just talking about the simple 80 plus upgrade or the 75 plus player pick like we had last week during Winter Wildcards Team 1. I'm talking about these sorts of packs. The base icon player pick that we had yesterday is kind of throwing us for a little bit of the loop, because usually these sorts of gamble pack SBCs, the fun upgrade pack SBCs like these, drop on Mondays as well. So the fact that this is already out, what's that going to mean for today? But I want to talk about this SBC, how it's impacting the market, and what that could mean for the market today as well, and the content today on Monday, as Mondays are usually pretty exciting days for content, also pretty exciting days for the market, as a lot of people see and expect the market to rise on Mondays as people get weekend league rewards and of course go out and build some teams. But of course, with all the objectives that are available right now, a lot of the grind is in draft or maybe in friendly modes where you don't need your most meta team. Will that deter people from going out and buying some promo cards or buying some cards off the market to better their squad after they get rewards? We'll talk about that and kind of the gameplay demand on the game this week, especially today on Monday, which is normally a day where we do see a market rise. But with all things considered, could the market rise be a little less because of that? So we're going to talk about a lot in today's video. So if you're excited for it, hit the thumbs up and subscribe if you're new. Let's start by just the Monday normal, right? The Monday normal is the regular upgrade pack, which you guys know the drill. Last week, we had a 75 plus player pick, right? And these are just the fun, repeatable SBCs that we do to try to pack promo cards. So maybe today they'll mix it up and give us like a double player pack. I really like those 80 plus doubles that came out a couple of weeks ago. But the best thing you can do to get your club ready for those SBCs today would just be, if you want to do those SBCs, by the way, definitely not like a huge, incredible investment opportunity. I don't think these non-rares or rares would move too much more than a couple hundred coins a piece, but stocking your club with non-rares at 350 coins or gold rares at 600, 650 coins is a very easy way to get those SBCs done for cheaper throughout this week or just today in general. Of course, that's the usual Monday upgrade pack SBC that we will see. I do expect those today, but the real question is, what's EA going to do? Because they dropped the base icon player pick yesterday on Saturday. And I mean, it's a decent value SBC. It's not terrible. But again, all I think of right now is, yes, there's a lot of fodder. There's going to be a lot more fodder we're able to get this week. A lot of people are going to do this SBC just because it's there and it's fun and it's a gamble. I mean, look at this, 74% upvotes for a 100,050 coin base icon player pick. I don't like this SBC because it's the base icon, right? I think it's a gamble. I've seen a lot of people do this and not get very good stuff. Of course, you could get some really, really great players like the Jarzinho base version. You could get Puskas, Ronaldinho, Eto, Mateus, right? You could get some really, really good players from this, but you could also get some really, really not so good players. And with how cheap the base icons are at this stage of the game, like even like Beckham's 150K. I mean, the value on this SBC is not bad at 150K, because there's a lot of base icons that are still at 150K or above. But also, I think a lot of people are disappointed with the outcome of this SBC. I would much more rather start working on a player SBC like Bellegarde, or if I have not done Eric Bailly or Silas, or just send that fodder into the Jarzinho or the Maldini icon SBCs. That's where I'm going to be putting my focus instead of this base icon player pick. But I'm not going to say it's a terrible decision if you want to go for the gamble, because 150K, two squads, 85, 86 is not that bad. So speaking of that SBC being yesterday, though, we'll talk about how that impacted the market here in just a second. But the trend is that usually these come out on Mondays, right? So this reminds me of just a couple of weeks ago in this game, we had the same situation happen. Maybe you guys might remember the 88 plus mid or FIFA World Cup icon upgrade, which personally I would rather have this again than to have this one, because mid or World Cup icons, that's, you know, better icons than base icons. But anyways, that's besides the point. This dropped on a Sunday, and what followed the Monday after, the day after, was just upgrade packs and maybe like the 85 plus double or something like really, really small. Could that be what happens today on this game? I think that's my favorite idea of what content might be today, because when EA dropped these big icon upgrades or just big gamble packs in general on Sundays, usually the day after that on Monday is just kind of a simple day where they do drop an upgrade pack SBC for, like, you know, just the gold upgrade, like 75 plus or the 81 plus, but then they don't do too much else other than that. Of course, one addition to that argument right now is EA just dropped even more stuff in objectives, right? They really want us to be focusing on gameplay right now to get the swap tokens in the First Owner Fiesta, in the Winter Wild Cards Cup, in the draft, right? With Foot Champ stuff, they want us to play games to get these tokens here. They're trying to get us to do these gameplay objectives, and that's where a lot of their focus has been put with the content. So that almost makes me think that the content this week might be a little bit slower, and that could be why today we maybe don't have another sort of gamble pack SBC, especially because we had this yesterday. So that's kind of what's in my mind. I think that is like my favorite and top, I guess, idea of what might be coming today. Of course, we all know that EA could have an idea of their own and they could do something crazy. I mean, guys, we have an 86 plus hero upgrade that was released last week that technically expires today, right? This SBC is expiring today. Could EA refresh it and drop an icon upgrade yesterday and then a hero upgrade again today? Who says they can't, right? They could absolutely go ahead and do that. So it's just going to depend on what the content is from EA to see what the market moves like today. But the reason why I'm saying that I don't think the content's going to be that spectacular today, or just to watch out for it, is if it isn't, our normal Monday market rise should see an additional rise after content today if the content is slow. Like, and by slow, I mean, even if we get like an 85 plus double, right? An 85 plus double pack, like they dropped last week, early in the week, would be a very, very possible SBC that we see today. That to me is not an expensive enough of an SBC or a hype enough of an SBC to make the market move that much, apart from maybe like your 83s and your 84s going up a little bit. So I'm not expecting content today to be that crazy. Now, could it? It still could be good, but I don't think it's going to be that nuts, which makes me think the market could rise even further after content. And today, it's all into EA's hands. So kind of just take this information with what it is. And if you're trying to flip some cards today like I am, you know, maybe if you see some really good prices before the 6 p.m. content drop today, maybe you look to sell some cards. But if you think that some of these cards could potentially go higher, then it is what it is. I've got a whole bunch of cards in my transfer list. I'm like 3.5 mil invested at the moment, just trying to work some stuff out and try to make some coins because the market does seem very healthy. But I do believe that it could be one of the last like solid market rises before we start to see maybe some downturn later on this week. And again, what's really going to make the market start to turn down later in this week and into this next weekend, and as we get closer and closer to team of the year, is the leaks. If people start deciding to panic sell, and whatever is going to cause that panic selling, whether it's insane content or leaks, I mean, I think we are due panic selling really, really soon. Again, I talked about it on the weekend. Prices are still pretty stable. We're still seeing a very healthy market, but I think we are getting to that window where the market's gone up now for like a week and a half, 2 weeks, and we're getting really close to team of the year. It's time really close again where the market is going to start to get panic sold and a lot of prices are going to drop off. So that's just kind of looming, right? But maybe it's not here just yet. Now, I want to talk about this icon player pick a little bit because you might be like, Nate, fodder went up a little bit yesterday because of this, but like it didn't go up like crazy. What if you're invested in fodder right now? What should you do? What should I do with fodder in my club? Well, this is why fodder didn't go up that much, because also yesterday we had a New Year's Cheer SBC, which is, I believe, where our token was. And it was a solid pack as well. If I can find the SBC, New Year's Kickoff, that's where it was. So they dropped a token in this and a tradable mega pack. Really, really good value SBC. It's like 3,000 coins to do for a tradable mega pack. That's a lot of supply for the market. You know where you can actually see this take place and really in action? If you take a look at the Index 100 on Footbin, you can see this, right? Content yesterday, the market rose for just a tiny bit, right? As a lot of your 83s and your 84s, they jumped up in price right away with that that icon player pick being out and the Bellegarde SBC being very cheap and requiring some low rated golds. You can see the 83s, boom, they went up a little bit, but now they're kind of back down. Same thing with 84s, right? The Index 84 was low, it boomed, but that supply from that mega pack and the tradable packs that you get from doing the base icon player pick kept supplying the market. And Bellegarde is two different SBCs as well. So there's a decent amount of tradable supply that hit the market yesterday, and that's what I think has kept these fodder prices going down, and the market in general, stuff that was in packs yesterday. I even think of like some of your basic gold cards. Now, Van Dijk is maybe not the best example, because the best of, the winter best of that we were talking about over the weekend, finally was released from packs. It's no longer in packs, and guys like Van Dijk and Gold Ronaldo went down a decent amount, but now they're back up a little bit, right? Because we had a lot of panic selling and a lot of supply since they were released back into packs as their special versions went out of packs. I think like Vinny Jr. was like 25,000 coins, I believe, and he went all the way down to like 20K. So that's a pretty sizable drop for that cheap of a card, right? 24,000 coins down to 18K. Now he's back up to about 20 to 21. So, you know, we had a really, really low point on the market with the combination of supply from the mega pack and from all the packs being open from the icon player pick segments and from the Bellegarde SBC segments. And you had panic selling on top of that for people that were selling cards to go and do the base icon player pick. But since we had all that supply, it didn't really move the fodder market. If you have fodder, you might as well just hold, right? Because think about it, still, we're getting daily player SBCs. And the only thing you have to be kind of, you know, knowing is coming out in this game this week with fodder is we're getting the big time FIFA World Cup rewards. We're going to talk about this more throughout the rest of the week this week. Do I believe that these rewards are going to crash fodder? No, not at all, because these are untradeable. What this is going to do is give people duplicates as they open the packs from this, or as they even, I believe yesterday, which I'm going to open mine on this video, everybody got 81 times 11s packs, or people are getting these from doing the completion objectives for the daily login. We're going to get an 83 times 10 on Tuesday after we complete the 12th and final Winter Wildcard daily login SBC. That's going to be a lot of fodder. I think that helps people go out and do SBCs because it's all untradeable, and I do believe you will see some parts of the SBC market continue to go up, specifically on the top tier, because especially if you're doing Jarzinho and you're packing a bunch of like 83s, 84s, and 85s, maybe a couple 86s, what are you going to have to go and buy? You're going to have to go and buy the 89s, the 90s, and the 91s, and these guys went down a little bit yesterday. I think they were even like 55K, 53K for De Bruyne yesterday. If you bought any of this high-rated fodder in this dip with all the supply, that was a fantastic, fantastic buy, because these cards are probably just going to slowly trickle up throughout the week as people are doing the Jarzinho, they're doing the Maldini SBC. Those are SBCs that people are probably going to start to do this week because there is a lot of fodder being given out. People are also, of course, going to be doing the base icon player pick and these lower tier player SBCs. And that's why I do think EA could put out like an 85 double today. And that's even an argument for EA putting out more upgrade pack SBCs this week, just because there's going to be so much fodder there that people are going to be getting. And EA, of course, are going to want to give people opportunities to turn that into different SBCs. So it's going to be a very interesting week because there's so much fodder available and there's going to be so much of an emphasis around SBCs, crafting, and getting stuff done and just feeling like you have a lot of cards. It's going to feel like we probably have cards in our unassigned all week because of the, you know, reward packs, objective packs, and of course those Qatar, the World Cup red player packs that we have all collected. So I'm going to open these really fast, my 81 times 11 really quick as well. And let's start talking about the market a little bit too. I know I mentioned it a little bit in this video, but with the demand being for like draft and with the objectives and the friendly modes, maybe there won't be as much of a demand on the market. We get a walkout here. Hold up, pause. We get Modric, Brozovic. All right, I can't complain. At least got a walkout out of my 81 times 11. Will the market, 286s. Let's go. All right. Only 181. All right. Okay. EA. Thank you. Appreciate it. Look, I have a duplicate. What do I have to go do? I don't want to quick sell that. I can go put that into a like draft token upgrade for 82 rated squad. W's. You know what I'm saying? So that, by the way, no man left behind. Like if you have duplicates like this, don't just quick sell them with so much fodder that is out. Don't quick sell that stuff this week because there is so much that you can do and craft and go and get, especially if EA drop player picks. That would be so much, yeah, that's just incredible amounts of fodder and so much, you know, so easy to grind and craft. Don't quick sell stuff. Just rinse it back into those cheap SBCs and just work on stuff throughout the week because you'll get a lot of stuff done. But will the market be hurt at all this week because of these objectives? And personally, I think that may happen a little bit, but I still think that especially I like the lower tier side of the market and just everything that people are going to be building teams around right now. There's just a lot of gameplay demand in general. People that played weekend league are getting the rewards and they might have gotten some cool cards and player picks and some good packs. And now they're motivated to continue playing the game and they're having fun on FIFA right now. So they're going to go and build teams. That's why I'm still pretty optimistic about a market rise today. I mean, I better be pretty optimistic if I spent over 3.5 million coins buying cards on bid and snipes. And, you know, I'm looking at this informed Marquinhos because he is up a little bit after the players that we got yesterday in the mini release. I'm trying to stick with what is hype, guys. And that is League One. The League One links are where people are building their teams right now. I noticed this Hakimi on bid. I thought it was a pretty cheap price in the low 400. So I went for that. I picked up a couple of Pepes from the mini release right around, I think it was like 55,000 coins. He's, you know, slowly rising a little bit. And I'm going to try to keep an eye on some of these other cards in the game. But I'm really focusing on what is hype. And that is the League One links on this market. So again, what I said in the beginning of the video is still holding true though. Some of these cards I might not sell before content today. A lot of times when we do our quick flips and we see a bit of a market rise on a Monday, we end up selling those cards around the content time or even before, because usually afterwards we see a dip in price. But you know, today that may not be the case if the content's not going to be that great. And some of these winter wild cards, we have to talk about this as well. Winter wild cards team two, if you go back a week ago to right now and looked at the winter wild cards team one, the Sunday, Monday, Tuesday time was a really, really low point, and honestly, like the low point for a lot of these cards. Conte's 950. What was he last Monday and Tuesday? 820, 814, and he just kept rising throughout the rest of the week. A lot of the player SBCs that we have coming, they don't look that insane. We have the Han, we have the Kenny right back from the Bundesliga, and then I believe we have Fadiga. Like, I think these are the only player SBCs that we have leaked right now, and that's 1, 2, 3 players. That would take us at least through part of the week this week. Maybe there's a couple more out there. Of course, we probably have a few more to be leaked. Maybe a surprise like the Hullet SBC was. But the leaked SBCs, for the players at least, the daily player SBCs, don't look that amazing, right? So that to me could mean that the market could rise pretty well. And maybe some of these winter wild cards from Team 2 are low-ish still today. But then as we head throughout the rest of the week today, or this week, just continue to rise. Unless we have some sort of panic situation and scenario, or EA drops some absolutely insane, nutty content that makes people sell cards to go get whatever content that is done, like a gamble pack, a player pick, or again, a loading screen or some leaks. So, you know, it's a big question mark right now with this market. And I'm trying to stay, I'm trying to stay pretty liquid apart from just being able to do some quick, safe, quick flips. I keep searching this Kimmich card, right? Because 580, he was like 660 last night. He's a really rare card. Do I think this is still overpriced for Kimmich? Absolutely. I think that, you know, in 2-3 weeks time, this guy's probably going to be under 500,000 coins just because he doesn't have 80 pace. And with Team of the Year on the horizon, I think he's going to end up dropping off in price a lot. I do feel like that still some of the winter wild cards from Team 1 are a bit overpriced. Like even Joao Felix and Ousmane Dembele, that's stuff that I would be careful with. But I think the time frame that we're in, the market that we're in right now, is still pretty safe. And I think it will be good opportunities to just quick flip cards in the next couple of days, if that's the way that you like to trade. But if you're like holding on to cards in your team because, you know, you're just wanting to see them rise in price and you think the market's going to keep going up, I think those days are numbered. So that's, you know, why I keep talking in these like different dynamics, right? In the short term, I feel like the market is healthy, but in the next 2 weeks, we got to be really, really careful with cards that we own. Now, a quick check and a quick update on the tokens. I don't want to make this video too long, of course, but we are up to 22 tokens. Yesterday, they dropped it in the New Year's kickoff SBC. A couple of tokens are expiring today on the 2nd of January, of course. So make sure you check this token tracker. I'll drop the link to this down below in the description if you don't know where this website is. And it tells you when the tokens expire and where they are in the game, whether it's an SBC or an objective. So make sure you go ahead and check those out there. We are on token number 22, so that means we are only guaranteed 3 more tokens in objectives, in SBCs, and the like. And if there's going to be any more tokens, they would be through the store, which we're running out of time on store token packs. EA's only dropped one through the Moment store and one, I believe, via the, was like a 75,000 coin pack. So we're EA, you got to fix up if you're going to drop us some bonus tokens. I don't believe we're getting all 30, especially with only 5 days left, I believe. Is that it? Is there only 5 days left of this, or 4 days left of the swaps program? The World Cup swaps go away in 2 days. And let me check these really fast. It's getting down to crunch time, guys. It really is. Let's see how many time this World Cup swaps, just so long. So these are still here for 11 days, but I'm pretty sure that the tokens are going to stop on the 6th of January. I'm pretty sure that EA tweeted that out. So these are still out for 11 days, which is nice. You have time to decide on what you want to do. I'm going to be putting my remaining tokens into the 83x25, getting that done. And hopefully getting some fodder to be able to craft Jarzinho. I'm going to start on my Jarzinho grind this week because it's that time, right? I think I might do Payet still, maybe DePaul, probably not. And then maybe I'll do a couple other lower tier SBCs, the cheap ones that have been dropped this week as well. But for me right now, this is just going to be an incredible week to grind, guys. Again, I said it in yesterday's video, this is such top tier content from EA. There is so much to do this week. Enjoy it, right? Enjoy it. With all the objective gameplay that is there, with all the packs you can earn, working up towards the Winter Wild Cards player packs, whether it's in the cup, whether it's in the daily login, or whether it's just the good packs that are in the draft objectives as well. Like, working up towards this stuff, just enjoy this week, because really, it's not going to get that much better than what we have right now in this game. So it's going to be a very interesting Monday. I'm excited to break it down with you guys and to just kind of react and to watch it all unfold live on stream today. If you're tuning in to content, tune in to twitch.tv/TheFutAccountant, link down below in the description. We'll be live streaming there at the content drop and a little before and after to kind of see what EA does. And maybe there'll be some leaks today. Maybe EA will surprise us a little bit. I don't know. But I do know we're probably getting upgrade packs. Maybe some other extra upgrade pack goodness. I want an 85 plus double back because those were good. EA, if you're listening, drop the 85 plus doubles. That'll make 84s go up. People will be happy for that investment. And also, those packs just seemed to be pretty decent on this game. So that's the video for today, guys. If you did enjoy, smash a thumbs up. Comment down below if you have any questions. And subscribe if you are new. It's been Nate the Foot Account. I'll catch you guys later. Peace out.